Hey guys, Moose78 here. Be sure to never miss another upload and click on the notifications icon to be alerted whenever a new video goes live. Hey guys, welcome back to American Truck Simulator. I am Moose78 and this is my ATS Let's Play series, Stories from the Road. Upload this twice a week, typically on a Tuesday and Thursday. Hope you guys are doing well today, by the way. And like I said, we're going to start to mix it up a little bit, get some different trucks in here. And today we are using the updated Kenworth T800. Don't know why, but I typically like to use this truck kind of as my heavy haul, large equipment truck. And we are hauling a little bit of a different cargo today than I typically haul. I know some of you guys have been asking for that, so we are going to start doing that a lot more. This is part of the Jazzy Cap mod. Picking up that big old thing and taking it over to Kingman, Arizona. Go ahead and get the truck started up here. Really like how this truck sounds. It's got kind of its own unique sound, so really like that. We'll go out here and get started. Bad sounding at all. It's kind of got that straight pipe sound to it a little bit. Kind of mess around with the Jake brake a little bit. Kind of curious to see how that sounds. I've not really used this truck. Well, I haven't used it at all since the latest update to it, so. Gotta get warmed up here. I think we got time to make it. Yeah, sounds pretty good overall, I guess. Too bad. Not too bad at all. As we get going here today, just kind of do another quick channel update. I know a couple of you guys have asked about the LS-PDFR content. It is coming here sooner than later. They recently did an update to GTA 5, so I'm in the process of going back and updating the game. Got LS-PDFR up and running again, so I'm pretty happy about that. I was a little bit worried about the whole update process. Thought I was going to have to completely do a fresh install of GTA 5. But fortunately, there were a couple of utilities out there. One was from Alvo, and the other one, I can't remember offhand what it was. But all it does is checks, you know, everything, like in your scripts folder, to see if there's any updates for anything. And there was quite a bit of stuff that I had to update. I think between that and Alvo's utility, I think I had to update probably 8 or so different mods. But all that's updated now. I'm just in the process of getting vehicles back in the game. I had the latest version of VX Bugs' Charger in the game working fine. And then I put in the FIB and Sheriff DLC pack from Officer 14, I believe it is. That was working okay, with the exception I only got 2 of the 3 vehicles to show up. I got that Charger to show up, as well as the Tahoe that's part of that pack. But for whatever reason, the CBPI would not show up. So I'm still working on that, but I tried to get a couple other cars installed, and that's where I ran into issues. The game just kept crashing. I was trying to get like another CBPI installed. Caused the game to crash, so I took that out. Everything was working fine, so I figured, well, I'm just gonna get you know, kind of the necessary mods that I need to get in. I need to get an updated corner van in game and an updated wrecker in game. So I tried to get the corner van in game and it just caused all sorts of issues. I'm not sure what I did wrong, but took that mod out and the game still wouldn't launch. So I'm completely starting fresh with installing cars. So hopefully I can get that sorted out tonight and later this week, yet still get some LSPDFR content recorded for maybe a late release this week, but shooting definitely for early next week. So we'll see how that goes. See if I can't drive all over the road here a little bit more. But someone had thrown out the idea of doing like a Monday, Wednesday, Friday upload for LSPDFR, and then Tuesday, Thursday for ATS. I might give that a shot. I just might give that a shot. Doesn't sound too bad. Kind of see how it goes though. I'm definitely excited to get into that mod and really play it, because what I have played of it, I really enjoy it. It's just something different, and there are just a ton of mods out there to kind of keep the game fresh, interesting. So I think I'll really enjoy that, and I think you guys will too. But of course, Tuesday is the early enlister release for Battlefield 1, and I will be playing the sweet bejesus out of that. I want to, the very least, do a walkthrough, a playthrough of the single player campaign and get that up on the channel. Then we'll just kind of see as time goes on what kind of content I want to post for Battlefield 1. You know, there's a lot of really, really good channels out there that cover Battlefield 1. You know, a lot of channels that do really good analysis, really get inside the numbers of the game, really get technical with it and all that stuff. So I'm not going to try to do, I don't think, any of that content. Sure, if I'm gonna get into weapon reviews and all that stuff. But so we'll just kind of see how it goes. But I definitely want to do a playthrough of the single player campaign and get that up on the channel. Because I've heard nothing but good things about the single player campaign, that it's really good, really in depth. So hopefully that's the case, because the last couple campaigns have not been all that good. You know, Battlefield 4's wasn't really all that good. Just a lot of cutscenes, and pretty much the same thing with Hardline. Even more so with Hardline, though, on the cutscenes. It was kind of ridiculous. I think I got to, like, the third part of the single-player campaign on that, and I was like, okay, I'm done. Just too many cutscenes. Just be up here on the left. Got track IR sorted back out. In the last episode, whenever I'd look around, my head was whipping around. It felt like at about a million mile an hour, so. Here we are. Looks like our trailer up there. Go in here and accept our job. There we go. That should be a pretty fun run. But yeah, as far as the channel, that's kind of what I got planned right now for the interim anyway. You know, get the LSPFR content going, keep the ATS content coming, and then maybe sprinkle in a little bit of Battlefield. But definitely LSPFR and ATS. Pull up just a little bit here. There we go. That's a lot better. I like the air brake sound on this. That's pretty cool. There we go. About to see what we got for... Okay. I wasn't sure if there would be any kind of animations or not. Let's take a look around real quick. Looks pretty good. Trail brakes are working good. Go ahead and get our beacons on. A quick pre-trip here. Make sure all our lights are working. Cab lights appear to be working. Trailer lights appear to be working. I think we are good to go to Kingman. Let's see how much weight we got on. About 60,000 pounds, so we are heavy, heavy. Can't remember offhand what engine I'm using in this. I'd have to go back and look, but I apologize for that. Seems like it's pulling it okay though, so that's a good thing. Not want to go into the other range for some reason. Drops back in okay, but just doesn't want to hop up into that next range. Cleared everything okay. Grab a screenshot there real quick. This being as heavy as it is, it doesn't feel like it's that heavy. Just passed a utility trailer back there. It reminded me, just downloaded the utility trailer pack off the Steam Workshop. Link for that is in the mod spreadsheet. Be sure to check that out. The mod spreadsheet is up to date. I'll be doing a little bit better job of that. And if you guys notice, and or you know, you guys are interested, at the bottom of the spreadsheet, you'll notice a tab down there for LSPDFR. That's not all the mods I'm using in-game. That's just all the mods I've downloaded for the game. As you know, I started to get that content posted and everything. I'm sure most of you guys that are familiar with the series and the mod and all that stuff will recognize the stuff that I'm actually using in game. So, but everything that I've downloaded for everything I've downloaded for so far is in that spreadsheet. So be sure to check that out. This T-800 pulls like an absolute bear or something. It just does not feel like I'm pulling 60,000 pounds. It's kind of weird. Come on, England, really? Well, at least it's pretty accurate, you know, as to how an England truck drives. Here we go. Oops. cool looking mod though. Using like a W900 day cab today, but I figure since I just drove the W900 the last episode, I figure I'd go ahead and use this. Resume the cruise and we are good to go. Doesn't sound too bad. Seen something on Twitter today, or actually on, this is actually Monday, I'm recording this, but seen something the other day on Twitter, looked like it got a lot of people excited. Sounds like there's going to be a Red Dead Redemption, or a Red Dead. Seen something on Twitter the other day that got a lot of people excited. Sounds like there's going to be another Red Dead game coming out here pretty soon. A lot of people think that the announcement's going to be coming here sooner than later, so that'll be interesting. Never played it, so might have to check that out. But with the new Battlefield game coming out, that's going to be pretty much the primary game that I'll be playing a lot of. Of course, I'll still be doing this. Of course, I'll still be doing LSPDFR. Which won't really leave much time for any other games, so probably be one of those games that's kind of wait and see how it is and all that good stuff. Update for the Division is coming out here pretty soon, 1.4, but I did play a little bit of the PTS, probably about 10-12 hours of that, and it was good, but it's just, man, with everything else that's going on right now, and with everything else that's coming out, it's just, just kind of lost interest in it. Thought that was going to be a lot closer than what it was, but they had plenty of time to merge on to the interstate, so we're good. Glad I got the latest update to the MHA map installed. It's good to have that back in the old mod folder. Definitely excited, as I'm sure all you guys are, for the next ATS official update. Big old map rescale. Just kind of curious as how close we are to an open beta for that. You would think, given the last update we had a few weeks back, that we'd be getting pretty close to it. But I have not seen anything yet. so far, pretty smooth sailing. Always get a little worried when I stop on the ramps. I don't know if this guy's really got a whole lot of room to back up. Got room to clear them. Well, this is good times. So I got a little room to back up. Smooth as I would have liked, but got through nonetheless. Not sure why my signs are looking like that, the road signs and all that. Might have to go back and fiddle with the NVIDIA Inspector a little bit. Farther we got to go here. We're coming through Bakersfield. And we still got a pretty good distance to go. Find a spot to stop here pretty soon. Get a quick rest in and pick it up in the next episode. looks like. Now there's nothing coming, so we'll go ahead and go on through. Looks like there should be a rest stop right around here. Just up here on the right, looks like. There we go. Well, guys, that's going to wrap it up for this episode of Stories on the Road. If you liked today's video, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch, helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around and consider doing so now. Guys, I'm going to cut on out here for the next episode. We will pick it up here just outside of Bakersfield and continue on to Kingman, Arizona. Until then, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. Also, if you want to follow me over on the Twitters, follow the link down in the video description. And if you're looking for great gaming gear at an affordable price, then be sure to check out my No Scope Gaming Glasses affiliate link, also down in the video description. And lastly, I upload 3 days a week, so be sure to check down below for my various content playlists for any videos you may have missed. Until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.